everyday life, sight and hearing are more important than smell. For example, your sense of sight lets you know when to stop at a red light, and your sense of hearing tells you to pay attention if you hear a car horn. These two senses allow us to avoid danger. But smell has a much deeper impact on our life than we think, especially when it comes to food. Our nose reacts to chemical stimuli. So how does that work in practice? First of all, odorous substances release volatile molecules into the air. These molecules are so small that your eyes can't see them, but your nose is able to smell them. When odor molecules reach the nose through the air we breathe, we talk about orthonasal olfaction. Nasal mucus comprises olfactory cells, which end in fine sensory filaments. We call these filaments the olfactory cilia. These brush-like cilia contain olfactory receptors, which fix the inhaled molecules. These molecules convey stimuli to the brain via the olfactory nerve, which is how we perceive different smells. In addition to this orthonasal olfaction, we perceive olfactory molecules retronasally, that is, via the mouth. As we heat up and chew food in our mouths, it releases odorous molecules. These molecules go up to the olfactory receptors via the pharynx. You'll sometimes hear about the smell of food, and sometimes you'll hear about its aroma. What is the difference? It's very simple. When odor molecules come from the air you breathe, we talk about smell. When they come from your mouth, we talk about the aroma of food. We can therefore conclude that we perceive odor molecules from food twice, once directly through the nose, and a second time indirectly via the mouth.